next generation devices. So that way we can work with them to keep functionality.
See, we're actually calling it right now.
Yeah. So we can work with them to keep functionality. So obviously,
so I'm here with HZO. Is that it?
Also preserves HZO.
Correct.
And you guys do basically nano coding technology, micro nanocoding?
Yes, we have a product called WaterBlock. It's a thin film coating that's applied to electronic devices to protect them from water damage. All these devices that you see in this water right here have been protected with WaterBlock. You can see they're immersed in the water and they continue to function. The idea of WaterBlock is to create devices that consumers can use with no fear. They can take your phone to the pool, take your phone to the beach, you can have your phone out and a rainstorm comes along. You won't have to worry that you're going to lose your very expensive smartphone because it got wet. So
we have the iPhone here, which is a consumer device that's being submerged. As a consumer, can I send you my Android or my iPhone? Can you help me protect what I have already purchased and invested in?
We are currently not providing services directly to consumers. We're working with the manufacturers. We want to make sure that WaterBlock maintains the integrity of the device, that there's no change in the functionality, so we're making sure that all we do is with the manufacturers. Our objective is to have WaterBlock included in the next generation of smartphones. So at that
like
point,
the Apples, the HTCs, the LGs, they can license your technology to use on their device if they want a waterproof phone or a water-safe phone, I guess.
The device manufacturers that we work with, yes, they would provide the phone to the consumers. That's correct.
So I know we've seen quite a few waterproof or water-safe devices on the market today. I know AT&T has a couple of tablets and smartphones.
Yes.
Verizon has announced some with their manufacturers. What's the difference between yours and these other products?
Sure. The thing that is unique about WaterBlock, first of all, many of the device protection systems out there are mechanical seals. So mechanical seals are great as long as you have all the seals in place. But as you know, smartphones have a lot of ports. They have charging ports and microphone ports and so forth. If one of those is open and it gets wet, the water will go inside and it will damage the device. There are other competitive products out there that apply a spray type of an application that is much, much thinner than what we do. So, and basically those competitive products are what I would call a repellent. So they're applied to the outside and they repel the water, which can provide some level of protection, but it's not the deep level of protection that WaterBlock can provide because it's a much thicker coating that's applied on the inside to all of the electronics. So it literally does block all of the electronics and puts a barrier between those electronics and water. So even though water may go inside the microphone port or the charging port or get inside the device, which water tends to do, it won't damage the device. It'll be okay. All you have to do is wait for it to dry out. It will function good as new. If you happen to put your smartphone, you leave it in your pocket and it goes through the washer, no problem. Still continue to function.
And this doesn't in any way affect the internal components or circuits in any way, right?
There is no impact whatsoever. There's no significant increase in heat or reduction of any function whatsoever. The phone continues to work as it did before.
Great, and this is HZO, so hopefully we'll see some or more manufacturers adopt this technology so we won't have any of those water damaged devices.
We hope so.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.